Now, so intention of this lecture or this video is to explain you how to work with the GitHub, right? So what I'll do, I'll go to the desktop and here sample git. If you know well and good how to work with the git, if you don't know, see how you are going to work with the git, right? So simple git is the folder, and this folder, let me open it into this. So I'm opening that folder into this. It's a desktop, and you can say what? Simple git. So VS Code says that I'm going to use this thing. Remember that whenever you start working with GitHub, right, make sure that first you create the git repository. Very first thing what you need to remember, creating a git repository. So let's go to the github/codecool, and then I can say example or explanation git, explanation git. But I'm creating this repository. Create the repo. Create what? Repo. So it has created one git repository here. So here you can say add the teams and collaborators. Means what this option is nothing but you can add particular team with whom you are going to work, right? And you can add the collaborators who are going to collaborate for this project. Okay, now this is one website, and on the one website I have performed the operation new repository. Let us understand the analogy of GitHub. What exactly GitHub is. Now if you go here, I'll go to the sketchpad. Now I would like to explain you what is GitHub. Consider that you are, someone of you is good mathematician, someone of you is good in the chemistry, and another one is good in what? Physics. So I write it here, maths, chemistry and physics. So these are what you can say, individual people. These are nothing but what? Individual people, right? And they are good at all these things. Suddenly they realize that, suddenly these guys realize that, now I am a good, right? So I want to create some JavaScript files, right? What I want to do, I want to, what you can say, convert my maths knowledge to the programming. I want other people to use my maths knowledge using what? JavaScript libraries. Means he or she would be creating, what you can say, simple JS files. You can say some maths.js, all other that JS, whatever they will create over here. We'll see exactly. So this guy will create 2 to 3 files, say algebra, alg.js, right? This guy will create, what you can say, same guy will create geometry.js. This will create formula, some integration, int.js. So these people will create the different set of library, set of JavaScript files. Library is nothing but, I'm defining the library. Library is nothing but set of needed files. In the case of Java, it is set of Java files is nothing but one library, right? In the case of JS, a set, or the set which is having same intention, means algebra giving a math, geometry giving a math solution, a integration.js giving a math solution. So all these file have same intention. They come together in one folder. That folder is called as what? Library. Means if you combine this in a one folder, this becomes what? Your library, something like this. Okay, now similarly this, this guy will create its own, what you can say, some .js files. For time being, I don't write it something like this. And this guy will also, on the quantum physics, on what you can say, vectors, scalars, everything he will define in his terms. Right? Now, they think that, or all that think that, let us do one thing, right? Let us make one common library. So these three people talk over the call or over the email, and they decide to create one autonomous library which contains all the maths related terms, chemistry related terms, and the physics related terms. So all these people, what you can say, are the JS developers. Consider that this says that these are nothing but what? JS developers. So they thought that let's build a platform on the top of what? JS. This programming language can be Java, Python, or anything else. Right. Now, math guy want to use some chemistry JS. Chemistry guy used to want some physics JS. Now, how they will integrate their own code? So this chemistry guy asked physics guy, please send me an email about your that particular file. Maths guy asked to physics guy, please send me the email by attaching the particular algebra.js file. See how complex it is. For 10-20 files, it is okay. But what if your project contains, this math guy is having 1000 files, and all 1000 files need to be given to him and the him. 2000 emails he need to send. Complexity. You can understand the complexity. And more complexity, right? He sits in US, he sits in UK, he sits in India. So no pen drive available over there. Certainly your email pack is going to be expired by heavy use of these things over the period of time. Now they get one discussion, what to do, how to solve this problem. And suddenly they Google and they found that there is one code integration software. So all three people are looking for what? Code integration software. Right, so they go to the Google and search what is a good code integration software. Suddenly they get to know that there is something called as GitHub. There is something called as what? GitHub. Now they understand the concepts of Git. They start learning the Git. They start acquiring the knowledge about Git. See, everyone is not complete, right? You have to acquire the knowledge one or the other day. But you need to have a right track. That is very important. Now see, this guy have found one software called as GitHub. So they went to the GitHub and they created one repository, something like what? Explanation Git. They have created this repository. Right. So one of them take charge and he or she says that let us use GitHub, right? And let us make one repository out of it. Let's create our first repo. That is nothing but what? Explanation Git. Exp what? Git. They created explanation.git. Now what they will do, all will clone the project. Very first thing. Or the first guy, what he will do, he creates it and clones the, what you can say, on his local machine, he is going to clone the empty repository. And this operation is called as what? Clone. Getting each and everything from the Git as it is called as what? Clone. So this guy has created the repo, right? This guy has initiated the repo, right? And he has downloaded the repo clone on his machine. Now see how that happens. Now I'll go to this simple Git folder. Instead of this, I'll go to the open in the containing folder. sample git, right? And there is one utility installed on your machine called as git. For the Windows guys, it is git scm you might have installed, right? For Linux guys, git is built in for some of the versions. So you can say first command git git clone clone, and what link of your repository, URL of your what repository, this URL. First operation is nothing but what clone operation, and you can paste it. See what I did? Git space clone space what URL in the particular folder. Let me hit the enter, right? And you can see this is empty, there is nothing. This is what empty, there is nothing. This is completely empty. Now this is the mathematician, so he creates one folder called as math. Inside the empty repository, it creates what one folder, and into this it creates one file called as math.js. That's it. And here he simple write console.log, you can say maths. Simple. You can consider that this is a very complex code he has written in the math.js, right? He has cloned the repository. Are you getting it? What he did, he has cloned the repository. If you can see this, there is a this folder, if you can see, this is a desktop sample git, and into that sample git explanation git has came, right? And into that math folder we created. Now earlier it was what empty. Now if you go to the terminal here and you say ll hyphen l means long listing with the math, with the math, there is a one more folder called as what dot git, hidden folder. There is one more hidden folder called as what git. So what is this folder? Let's go inside that folder dot git and ls hyphen l. You can see you go inside dot git and ls hyphen, don't need to write, I'm recording the session, you can repeat anytime, right? Now see here you will find branches, config, description, hook, and something like this dot git. And this folder, whatever dot git folder is available inside this clone folder, is called as your local repository configuration and other things, right? Is called as what local repository. So local technically can be copy of your remote repo, which is nothing but this. This local can be copy of what remote repo. Might be local can be different than the remote repo, that's not an issue. In this case it is different. So your remote is having empty thing, but in this case your local is having what one math folder, and inside that folder there is what one math.js file. Means your local, in my case my local and the remote are what difference, there is a difference, right? And that's why here one bubble it is showing, it is related to the VS code, and that's why it is showing what bubble. This says that there is some difference between remote and local, one difference, bubble one showing, right? Which says that there is a one difference. So click here and can you see it is saying that this is a new file math.js, right? Now what when you click over here, when you click over here, what exactly happens, what it is telling you, it is telling you that there is a difference, right? So you need to perform another operation to remove that difference, right? To remove that difference, see here what exactly you need to do. So I cloned it, I added one more file inside this, and there is why it is showing the difference. Now first, all the unmatched files, all the unmatched files need to be added, need to what, added to the local repository. Now see what I'll do here, you can say math So adding math library. Now see, VS Code automatically adds. Means when you create the code, it automatically adds. If you see, this is a green colored one. This is what green colored means, it has already added it. When you, there is a difference, it adds it automatically. Right. Now when you go here, it is saying that yes, I have added it to the, what you can say, local repository. Now I want to commit it. So commit operation is that operation. So I'm writing the operations here. You can check it. First operation we have seen is nothing but what? Clone. After the clone, you are going to do what? Your changes. You are going to perform what? Your changes, and you are going to what? Add it. In the case of VS Code, VS Code does this on its own. After the add, whatever code you have added to the local repository, that need to be committed. Now what is commit? What is commit? At the next push will send this code to remote repo. So what is commit? Commit will add all the code to the local repository, right? And whenever you are going to push the code, all this committed code would be reflected to what? Your remote repository. See now what happens. Adding math library. See, you are giving, for the commit you need to explain what change you are doing. So here math guy is saying that maths, I'm adding math library, and if you see this tick, click on this, it will commit this code. It will commit this code, and then you can say push once again. Next operation is what? Your push. So after the commit, your next operation is what? You can say push, which will actually push the code from the local repository to what? Remote repository. Actual push code from the local to what? Remote. See now. So it is asking where to push. Can you see username? It is asking username of your Git username. So my username is DDHHA and the password. Hit the enter. Okay. Now first you clone. Clone means fresh. What do you mean by clone? Fresh. Getting a fresh data. Then there is nothing but what? Add, which VS Code does internally. If you make some change, that is going to be added. Then what? Commit. Commit is nothing but what? Next candidate for releasing. Whatever you are going to commit, that would be released to the remote at the next level. Now go here and refresh your repo. Refresh it. You will find all that code. Can you see? One math folder is coming here, and in a math folder, here is the comment. Maths, adding math library. Now here you can check the commits. One commit has been made by me. So who has made what commit, you can check it here. And even what code has been committed, that also you can check. See, only one line of, this is your server side earlier, and this is a new one. This one line of code has been added. It is showing you clearly. Right. Now, another operation is pull. Another operation is what? Pull. Consider that now in our architecture diagram, all these, what you can say, clone the code at the first time, clone the code at the first time, right? Remember that all these people will what? Clone. So first operation is nothing but what you can say, clone. Here also you can say clone. First time they will clone it. Now whenever this chemistry guy is going to clone the code, he is going to get repository with what? Maths code. Right? Then what chemistry guy will do? He is going to add his library, and again he is going to push the code here. So clone, push, clone, add, commit, push, clone, add, commit, push. So this is nothing but what the push is. Now what he is going to push? Chemistry guy, chemistry guy is going to push math data plus chemistry data right to the repository. Now this remote repository is having what? Math data plus chemistry data. Means whenever physics guy is going to clone the project, he is going to get math, physics and the chemistry, right? And whenever he is going to push the code, he is going to push all three codes. Code has been integrated. Now once code has been integrated properly, right, there is a no clone. Second time there is no clone until you get some problem. There is a pull. Pull means what? Only get required changes, not all the changes, not all repository like clones gives you. You are going to get what needed. Consider that all them has pushed their codes. Now this repository is having all three codes, chemistry, maths and the physics, and physics guy has changed one formula. Again he has what? Pushed the code. But whenever you are going to push second time, first pull the code. Why? Other might have pushed the code. That code need to be on your machine, right? Whenever you push second time, make sure that you will pull the code first and then push it. Means what? Before pushing, so let me add one more folder called as, what you can say, new folder and chemistry. What's that? Move. And in the chemistry I can add new file, chem.js and console.log, and here you can say chem. Okay, now see green one, this is white one, and this is what? Green one, which means that this is not matching. Now right, what you will do, click on this bubble and here you can say chemistry, right, adding chem library and commit it. See, we are committing it. Now before pushing, I'm doing pull. Pull will go to the particular repository and pull all needed changes, right? I have pulled it. Now I can what? Push it again. Again you need to provide username. Like this. This is what the GitHub is. Now you might got to know what GitHub is, where it is going to be used, why it is going to be used. And you create your own repository like you have created, right? Clone the first, and into the clone repository start adding your codes, so that your codes would still remain on the GitHub forever. Forever. You don't need to worry about the time. That's what the GitHub is all about. Now I would like to ask your queries. Do you have any queries? Any queries if you have, you can ask me.